was trying to switch back heel on Wallenberg. I went back 5 times.
Duh, what am I talking about? A video days. Gons. First time I saw someone skate it was Mark. You can see in the footage that it's jacked. Like, it's so big. That frontside 180 after it is amazing. You know once somebody does something, it's possible. Once the door's got a little crack in it, like Mark Ollie in it, okay, next step is this. I just remember a couple times just being, fuck, this is long. It's a lot of time in the air.
The first time we went to Wallenberg was a really weird day.
We were filming for 1947, the LRG video.
We needed to go and shoot a vertical photo of his switchback Smith on the Stanford Hubba.
And he made it happen like that. And we were just all floored. That is like monumental, super big, you know, MBD on the Hubba.
You do that like Dave Dunn, like that. We won. To get that and then go to Wallenberg is pretty strange.
You sure your body's good? And he seemed like he was on point.
Yeah, we just darted all the way to Frisco and pulled up and the ramp got set up.
So back in the day, we would cut the gate, you know, people skate down the hill to get enough speed.
Go over the sidewalk, curve around. There was all this room to do all this.
I think they built something in the way so you can't approach it from that direction.
Like a handicap ramp.
So now we have to bring the ramp.
You have to get a giant truck to transport that thing. You gotta get it over a fence, and you have to build it all together, skate it, and then take it down, take the ramp back to the warehouse, and then take the truck back to the rental place. It sucks.
Shit, it's a pain in the ass.
The ramp is intimidating.
You're like at the top, and then all of a sudden you're at the front, so it's a whole different aspect, no, but it's still big. You know, like it's still Wallenberg. How you got there is just was part of your story, you know.
So cool. I didn't think the ramp was gonna be like this, so.
Actually, no, I don't even think I'd ever been there. I was like, oh shit, this thing is fucking super long. Like, I wonder how it's gonna be to clear it. You gotta set up before you drop in. Once you hit the bottom, you're like, damn, you're at the top. Yeah, after like flying past the first one, I was like, all right, cool. Like, I know I can clear it. But you really have to still try to like pump the ramp as hard as possible. One of the homies was skating it with me too, Andy Dicker. He like ollied it. We were both like rolling it, kind of hyping each other up to try to skate it. I stuck it relatively quick, actually.
I thought for sure he was gonna do it within like 10 tries.
You can jump down it for a while, but definitely after like 15, 20 tries, you get to a point where you're like, your legs are so shot, like even if you do stick it, you're just gonna like splat. So probably like solid hour and a half.
He was like, let's come back. We're gonna get this for the video. Even though like the process sucks, I was 100% confident in Miles the whole time.
He didn't get it the first time. I thought for sure he was gonna get it the second time. I did not think it was gonna go past a second attempt.
It would have been great, but his part was still amazing. It just didn't happen. Every time it was right there. That last time we went, he was like, I'm done with it. I don't want to come back here.
Yeah, I was just gonna let it go. Like, I'll get there when I get there. Cause a couple times I went there, like, I'm not leaving until I like can't fucking walk.
Yeah, it had been a couple years since he tried last. And he'd obviously gotten somehow better than he already was at skating. And he was like, hey, I want to do it again. I want to try it again. Cool, I'm in, let's do it.
The weather that day specifically was like the best weather it had been every single time. The wind comes in and for some reason it always blows the opposite fucking way. Out of all the tries, there was like the most people skating it with me.
But Miles was like, hey, it's a party, let's like bring the homies.
We had James trying to ollie it. The homie Robbie was trying to ollie it. Mark Tucci was skating it.
it was cool because he wanted to invite as many people as possible.
Suchu ollied it pretty quick. James, it took him a little bit, and then he finally like did one. I was like, all right, for sure, like, I gotta get this back. Really tried to land it, pumped super hard down the ramp, and then I stuck it and slipped out. I thought for sure, like when I caught it, I was like, oh, this is the one. I was like right on top of it, and then I slipped out. Right before I landed it, I was starting to get like, I was like, fuck, like this, I stuck it already like 4 or 5 times. Like this shit has to work soon. Like my legs are getting tired. And like I rode in a couple times. It was too windy to try, so I didn't want to waste the try. It's got to happen in the next couple tries. And then sure enough, like set up, tighten my trucks a little bit, just tried to pump the ramp super hard and fucking that shit just worked.
Make looks so good. You're just like, how could he have worked for that? Oh, they set the roll in up, did a couple jumping jacks, and he did it. Like, that's how easy it looked.
Looked like nothing for him.
But I hella blacked out. Like, I remember like popping, but I don't really remember like the trick working or like, oh shit, I see grip tape.
When he rolled away, he turned around, looked at his homies. I just know it was like a huge weight being lifted off his shoulders.
I was kind of in like a weird shock. Like, I didn't think it really happened.
Over 4 years or 3 years or whatever it was, that's gnarly.
People don't realize like what it takes for something like that to go down.
Most people will like be like, all right, I tried it, I'm gonna leave it in the past. He's like, no, I'm getting older and I'm gonna do it. So hey, he's like fine wine, man. He keeps going and going.
Yeah, it feels sick to be on that list, but it's more for myself, like getting that shit out of the way because I tried it so many times. Every time going there, like, all right, I'm gonna do it this time. Like, it's for sure going down, and then it just not happening, and then finally working out is more just like satisfaction for like my personal getting that trick off my chest and move on or whatever.
It's a historic, important, iconic spot in skateboarding.
Yeah, it's a measuring stick. It's a good reference to be like, that was fucking big.
Buster Bill. It's either you Buster Bill and today, Miles bust that shit.
Exactly.
Ain't no Bill. Bust down. Wallenberg. It's over. It's over.
It's done.
You know, you try to put your foot on the third step, or if you're going too slow and that pistol, it just, you know, they're just, you want chocolate? Who loves chocolate? Tom loves chocolate.